Hey guys, so if you saw yesterday's video, I looked into the island of Survivio. Well, today we'll be looking at the bunkers and some confidential documents with a lot of information on them. So yeah, let's get right into it.
Initiative was created in 1983. Before the initiative arrived, Soviet scientists here worked to understand the unique ornithological characteristics of the island.
So this is the second video that was uploaded on the official Surviv channel to provide a bit more of a background behind Palmer. If we try and keep some sort of timeline of events, the sailing ship in the previous videos was around 1808, and now there's a massive gap to the Palmer initiative in 1983. So that's over 100 years, and in between that time, all we know that Soviet scientists were working on trying to understand the mythological properties of the island. So they'd been involved, I'm not sure for how long or what they've got up to, we haven't really got any details. So who exactly are Palmer Initiative? Well, Palmer stands for Poultry Applications and Research on Metabolic Augmentation. Poultry as in domestic fowl such as chickens, turkeys, ducks and geese. And then metabolic augmentation, so looking at life and trying to extend it or enhance it. In brief, they were using chickens to try and make superhumans. Okay, let's have a look at the confidential documents. So for anyone that saw the deleted video, I was trying to use brightness and contrast to try and see certain words that were blacked out. It turns out the complete documents were revealed, so we can just have a look at them. First document, dated 1984, is telling us about a construction proposal for Bunker 3. Bunker 3 is the Hydra, and it's going to be used into the research of physical and mental enhancements through poultry-based applications. Okay, so this looks like it's got Palmer written all over it. So that's in February, and by May they plan to begin construction. And then there's a contract in place with Cougar Heavy Industries to act as a primary subcontractor. And then that company's got a proof of concept for Bunker 16, the Chrysanthemum, and it's completed and passed inspection. I'm not going to look into this point too much, as the next video I'm planning to do is looking at what's in the Chrysanthemum and behind the wall, so I'm going to leave that one for now. And then cryostasis chambers and subsystems to be provided by the Academy of Sciences upon completion of primary bunker compartments, freezing a person for later resuscitation. So I've heard theories from people suggesting the people in the chambers are dead or zombies. This suggests that they were actually alive and they've just been frozen. And the next point, Bunker 3 weapons closet to act as temporary storage for PI, Department of Advanced Weapons, until completion of Bunker 5, the hatchet. The Hydra was built before the hatchet, and then that final room you see at the end where you normally get the vector from, that is temporary storage until the hatchet is built. And then someone's wrote on top of it, don't go to 5, 5 is die. Well, we've now been shown what's in Bunker 5. Whoever's wrote that was pretty terrified going in there, or knows something that we don't. And the next document is dated 1993, so that's 9 years later. In that time, a lot has happened. This is a status report to Bunker 1 from the Egg Bunker. Connection to final recording devices expired on 13 April. Last recordings show test subjects fighting in and around the mansion with Soviet incursion forces. On 15 April, Dr. Jackson exited the bunker in attempt to reach Bunker 17, the Fowl. Okay, that's quite a lot to take in. For some reason, the Soviet forces are fighting the test subjects in the mansion. This suggests that the experiments were a success. However, the test subjects have rebelled, or for some reason the Soviet have decided to attack them. Maybe they were too strong. And here's one of the voice recordings to confirm these suspicions.
Ironic, is it not? We warned the Kremlin that this place was highly unstable, beyond their capabilities to control. And yet here we are, repeating the mistakes of the past.
At the start of the video, I mentioned the Soviet scientists had researched here before, and now we know that even at this first attempt, something went wrong. That same thing has happened again, and most likely relates to the influence of the eye on the island. Dr. Tallow also mentions an accident occurring. Most believe it is either the subjects become too strong or the eye did something, but this accident is still a huge mystery in the lore of Surviv.
Not long after the experiments began, however, there was an accident.
On the 22nd of April, Dr. Richards was found dead from intentional cyanide poisoning. His remains have been placed in the northwest corner with the others. You might recognize the name of Dr. Richards, as he's also in one of the voice recordings we've received.
This is Dr. Chandler Tallow. We sealed the eye, but I fear we have not seen the last. Richards? What are you? No. No! Dr. Richards!
The obvious link here is, whilst he's talking, he can see Dr. Richards about to take the cyanide. And then point four is just telling us that they're low on water, the chicken supply is exhausted, and the remaining team members have decided to destroy the data and recordings, and then following Dr. Richards in taking cyanide pills to kill themselves. They don't want to leave behind any evidence of their wrongdoings or for anyone to find out what they've been up to, and it seems like they're scared of the test subjects or something else, so they're not willing to leave the bunker. There are quite a few interesting details in those two documents. So within those 9 years, a lot has happened. It'd be interesting to get a few more releases of such documents or clues as to what's happening between then. I thought it'd be a good idea to have a quick overview of each bunker to see exactly what we know so far and what's missing. Starting from the top, Bunker 1 is the headquarters. It's mentioned in the second confidential document. We haven't been shown the logo for this bunker, and yeah, many believe it is the eye bunker which Palmer uses to control all the other bunkers. Bunker 2 is the swine bunker. For anyone that played the Halloween update, that's where we first saw the symbol. So beyond the logo and name of bunker, we don't really know too much about this one either. Then we've got Bunker 3, the Hydra bunker. I think we've gone over most of this in depth and understand what the bunker was used for. Bunker 4 is the crossing bunker. The bunker orientation video used this bunker as an example, so nothing too special about this bunker. Bunker 5 is the hatchet bunker. So the primary function of this bunker seems to be weapon storage, and in-game you can see you get all the best weapons from there, including the USAS 12 M249 fire axe and recently the stone hammer. Bunker 6 is the harpsichord, again found in the chamber of the eye bunker. And if we go back to that first document, although it doesn't show the name, it does show that this person is lead researcher. Bunker 7, the caduceus, can have one of two meanings, as it's a staff that was carried by Hermes in Greek mythology. May suggest that this is a room full of messages, such as the voice recordings or maybe other documents, and in general for communication purposes. The second theory is, as the symbol is also used as a symbol of medicine, this room may be where they kept their medical supplies. Bunker 8, the egg, is a tiny bunker, as we've seen from the second confidential document, most likely used as a survival bunker. Bunker 9, the cloud, we haven't really got any information about this, apart from the name and logo again. One theory is that it might relate to the term cloud 9, which is a sort of out-of-body experience. So bunker 10 is the storm bunker, and when this one was released, I was really excited, as I thought maybe it's some way to survive the storm. From the footage here, you can see I tried to outheal the storm. I thought maybe eventually you won't take damage, but that didn't seem the case. And quite a lot of people actually feel that this bunker isn't to survive the storm, it's used to control the storm. Bunker 11, there isn't any information about. Bunker 12 is the conch bunker. That's the one that spawns around the island shores. Little or no information beyond that is known. Same with bunker 13 and 14, yet to be discovered. Bunker 15 is the meteor, the symbol you might recognize from airdrops. The most likely theory behind this bunker is it's used to send out the airdrops to the survivors. Bunker 16 is the chrysanthemum bunker. So that's the most recent addition to the game and can be found underneath the greenhouse. How big this bunker is yet to be determined, as it seems to be a room or multiple rooms that we don't have access to at the moment. But yeah, I'm going to talk about this more in the next video. And then we've got Bunker 17, the fowl, mentioned in the second confidential document. And the logic behind this one seems to be it was used for food and resources storage, as that's where the scientists were trying to get to when they were low on those resources. There's nothing to suggest that there won't be any more bunkers. I initially thought there was 16 from this audio clip.
We buried the 16 in the waters, and that is when the Russian fishing vessel found us.
So my theory was that there's a link with the 16 buried people to the bunkers, but that doesn't seem to add up anymore. Again, a massive shout out to the Surviv Leak server and owner for helping me put together some of this information. A link to join that Discord server will be in the description below, so do check it out if you're really interested in learning more. Next video, I'm going to look at what is behind the wall. So that's the room in the Chrysanthemum bunker. And thanks to everyone who commented on the last video and showed your support to this type of video. But yeah, that's all for now. See you soon. Peace.